Blessings with you, Evangelist Martin Orozco. I want to share with you today a word of God. Remember, not only of bread the man will live, but of any word that comes from the mouth of our God. Lord, I pray in this morning that you bless those that are listening this word, that their heart be touched by the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit bring blessing, that the Holy Spirit bring understanding, that their eyes be enlightened, that their heart be moved to you, Jesus. I pray to you, God, that somebody listen to this and come to repentance, confess of sin, and that you, Holy Spirit, bless them with the gift of salvation, which is only in Jesus' name. The title of this transmission is To Whom You Pledge Your Alliance. To who you are committed to. You know, nowadays, but before, let's read the Bible. The Bible is the first thing we need to do. It says in Acts of the Apostles, chapter 17, according to the New Living Translation, it says, and Jason has welcomed them into his home. They are all guilty of treason against Caesar, for they profess alliance to another king named Jesus. Wow, what a word. What we found here is totally amazing. It's shocking. It says that there was a guy called Jason who welcomed the apostle in her house. He welcomed the word of God in his house. And one of the reasons was because the city of the Jews and the Roman were accusing of Apostle Paul and his collaborators of something. Look at what it says. They are all guilty of treason against Caesar, for they profess alliance to another king named Jesus. Let me tell you, at the time when this happened, the social, political condition, circumstance are completely different than today. Today we can ask, to who you pledge your alliance? Well, if you live in America, it's a common saying that they play the alliance to the flag and to the national anthem. Other circumstance where you pledge your alliance is you political active in a group, you are a member of that political party, could be whatever party, political party, so you compromise yourself to pledge your alliance to that group. Nowadays, alliance can be translated as a loyalty. You need to be loyal to that group. You need to identify with that group. In our social structure, in our social environment, we pledge our loyalty in family, friends. Politically, well, you know, you have to be an activist to pledge your loyalty to your belief. But in any case, when you pledge your loyalty or your alliance, it's not a matter of life and death, okay? If you belong to a party, one day you decide to leave the party, the people say, okay, bye-bye. I guess you're not a member of the party anymore. If you are not loyal to your spouse, you're going to be in trouble, probably a legal divorce, but nobody is going to die. It's going to be painful, though, for the kid and for the people. But if you are loyal to your friend or they're not loyal to you, well, you know, they're going to hurt your feelings, but it don't go more than that. Nowadays, loyalty and alliance is more like a something of mutual convenience, something that allow you to belong to, is something that at the end it can benefit you or can benefit others, or it's up to you. Okay, nowadays that's the way we pledge our alliance or our loyalty to somebody. But at the time this Bible verse was written, the concept of alliance and loyalty was a matter of death and life. The apostle, they were preaching Jesus Christ as a Lord, as a King. And this represents a serious problem for the Jewish and for the Romans. For one part, the Romans declared that the only Lord and the only God is Caesar. Nobody has the right to pledge his alliance to something different than Caesar. That means condemnation. If you were a Roman citizen or you live in any domain of Roman control and power, you belong to the Caesar and you need to come with complete loyalty by praising him verbally, by giving offerings, by giving taxes, and living according to the way of life of the Roman imposed in any territory that they control. You belong to the Caesar back in those days. But here we come, a group of carpenters, a group of fishers, a group of nobodies. They don't have titles, they don't have even the Roman citizen. They were from Judea, they were poor people, their aspect it was of the, like Roman said, the plebe was the lowest class in the Roman Empire. They don't belong to the consul, they don't belong to the high society, they were not even Roman citizens. They were from Judea. And those guys from Judea, they were proclaiming that there was a king. And this king, his name was Jesus. And it does not matter what was the law back in those days. Let me tell you, these guys, led by Apostle Paul and all the churches, they proclaimed that there was not only that Caesar was king, they said that Jesus was the only king. These people suffered death. These people suffered persecution. These people suffered the horror of the persecution of the Roman and the Jews, because they proclaimed Jesus as a King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And not only that, they even sing that in when they meet. The Philippians chapter 2 is a hymn which declare that Jesus is Lord and the only Lord and only King. And they said that all thumb and all knee will bow in front of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. So back in those days, those brother and sister, they pledged his complete alliance and loyalty to death, to the King of Kings and Lord, the Lord Jesus Christ. Today, maybe it's no matter yet of life and death, but it will come to a point that yes, it will be a matter of death and life. But today, let me ask you, to who you pledge your alliance? To this world? You live, you serve, you go according to this world, according to the Caesar that demand you your time, demand you money, demand to you satisfy your pleasure according to the flesh and according to this world? Or you pledge your alliance to Jesus, King of Kings and Lord of Lords? Let me tell you, today you need to make a stand. Today, if you stand for Jesus, Jesus will stand for you in the final day for salvation. Through repentance, through confession of your sin, rise up in faith and confess Jesus as a Lord and Lord and King of Kings, pledge your life and your alliance to the only that can save, the only one that died at the cross and resurrected with power and glory. Don't miss this opportunity. The King of Kings is coming soon, and you will give account to whom you pledge your alliance. God bless you.